Number 9. Chernobyl Reactor Number 4 Room. Located in northern Ukraine, Pripyat was founded in 1970 as a closed-off city that existed solely to serve the nearby Chernobyl nuclear plant. Unfortunately, things went terribly wrong on April 26, 1986. That's when the plant's number 4 reactor malfunctioned, triggering history's worst-ever nuclear disaster. Two staff members who operated the reactor instantly died, and 134 others were hospitalized shortly after that. Radiation equaling 500 Hiroshima bombs spewed into the air. Nearly 50,000 residents were evacuated from Pripyat, leaving the area virtually abandoned except for personnel who were tasked with the dangerous job of cleaning the mess up. The city's deserted buildings have been a popular attraction for quite some time, offering visitors a first-hand glimpse at a place left frozen in time. The Chernobyl plant has been less accessible to tourists in the past, but that's slowly changing. In late 2019, the control room for Nuclear Reactor 4, the one that exploded, opened to the public for the first time. Visitors could only gain entry by a guided tour and were required to wear a hazmat suit, a respirator, and a protective helmet. They also had to submit to radiation tests upon entering and leaving and could only stay in the control room for a few minutes. This was because the radiation levels remain dangerous to this day. It's unclear whether the tours are still running amid the ongoing COVID-19 pandemic and the Russian invasion of Ukraine. Is this a tour you'd like to take? Number 8. Paderai Prison. Near the old town of Tallinn along Estonia's northern coast, there's an abandoned jail known as Paderai Prison. It was initially built as a sea fortress around 1840 and began functioning as a prison during World War II. The Soviets used the site as a high-security lockup from 1944 to 1991, during which time it earned a reputation as one of the country's most terrifying prisons. At any given time, there were hundreds of inmates at Paderai, including hardened criminals and political captives. They were subjected to brutal KGB interrogations and abuse, and many were executed. The prison was abandoned in 2004 when Estonia joined the European Union. It's open to the public as a museum, but very little has been done to preserve or restore the site. Visitors see Paderai precisely as it was left, along with the effects of time and the elements. Some cells still contain books, magazines, and other personal belongings left behind by prisoners. Estonian-Canadian sisters Lisa and Kristen Dobbin visited Paderai Prison during a quest to learn more about their ancestral heritage. They likened the facility to the setting of a Stanley Kubrick film, describing it in a blog for Estonian World as a dark psychological thriller about loneliness and lives misspent. The sisters also reported feeling overwhelmed with dread and anxiety during their tour. One of Paderai Prison's most disturbing features is its operating room, which carries a distinctive unpleasant odor and still contains an old bedpan, glass bottles that once held medical fluids, and obsolete equipment. Number 7. Jayamana. Located in Romania's Apuseni Mountains, the Rosia Poeni mine was once Europe's second largest copper mine, employing around 500 people at its peak. It was established during the first half of the 20th century after copper deposits were discovered nearby the village of Jayamana. Nearby residents' lives were turned upside down in 1977 when representatives of the then-dictator Nicolae Ceausescu showed up and told them they had to pack up and leave. Engineers needed somewhere to dump toxic wastewater from the copper mine, and Jayamana was chosen as the place for it. Villagers were offered $2,000 for their properties and were told that they would be moving to a town close by. But the government failed to keep most of its promises, and between 300 and 400 families were scattered throughout the country. Authorities also failed to move the graves of Jayamana's deceased residents as promised. The village was replaced with an artificial lake filled with hazardous sludge and runoff from Rosia Poeni. It contains dangerous chemicals, including cyanide and other substances, which have turned the water a bright red color. The only visible remnant of Jayamana is a church spire that juts out eerily from the lake's surface. Number 6. The Capuchin Crypt. From the outside looking in, the Santa Maria della Concezione de Cappuccini, or Our Lady of the Conception of the Capuchins, looks pretty ordinary. But beneath the historical chapel in Rome, Italy, there's a series of crypts with the skeletal remains of over 4,000 friars covering the walls and ceilings. Some of the bones are arranged into patterns that are thought to have some sort of religious significance, while other skeletons are dressed in traditional Franciscan attire. The church was commissioned in 1626 by Pope Urban VIII and was completed in 1631. That same year, a member of the Capuchin order named Cardinal Antonio Barberini ordered for the remains of thousands of friars to be exhumed from their original resting places and moved to the church's crypt. Experts have dated the bones to a nearly 400-year period from 1500 to 1870. There are 5 chapels in the crypt, and they rely exclusively on a very limited supply of natural light, effectively adding to the site's eeriness. Several noteworthy historical figures have visited, including the Marquis de Sade and Mark Twain. It's also said that the crypt inspired other famous skeleton-covered sites throughout the world, including the Sedlec Ossuary in the Czech Republic and the Skull Chapel in Poland. If you visited this crypt, who would you take with you? Let me know in the comments. Remember to subscribe to the channel to see more videos like this one. Number 5. Plymouth. The former town of Plymouth once served as the principal port for Montserrat, a British overseas territory located in the West Indies. It sat in the island's shadow of the Soufriere Hills volcano, which was dormant for centuries before it suddenly erupted again in 1995. Plymouth was quickly buried in mud and ash, earning it the nickname Pompeii of the Caribbean. The eruption killed at least 19 people and destroyed the island's major airport as authorities rushed to evacuate around 4,000 civilians. Today, Plymouth remains encased chiefly in ash. Partially buried buildings and cars still line the streets that many people had known their entire lives. This was before they had to leave one day with almost no warning and start over elsewhere. There's very little grass or vegetation, giving the ghost town an eerie post-apocalyptic feel. It's easy to tell just by looking around that something terrible and unexpected happened there. Some parts of Plymouth were damaged worse than others. For example, the only remaining visible remnants of a neighborhood called Amersham are the tops of the only two buildings that weren't completely buried. When pyroclastic flows barreled through the streets, everything was left in ruins. But even in the less damaged settlements, the electrical and plumbing infrastructures were utterly destroyed, leaving the entire area uninhabitable. The disaster triggered a mass exodus. About two-thirds of Montserrat's residents ended up leaving and never returned, and by 1997 its total population had dwindled to fewer than 1,200. In addition, the island's economy was hard hit, mainly because Plymouth was its largest city and tourist attraction. Volcanic activity has quieted dramatically in recent years, but still continues. As a result, Plymouth and several other abandoned towns are surrounded by an exclusion zone where nobody's allowed to live and almost nobody is allowed to visit. A new port and settlement are being built in the northwest section of the small island, which measures just 10 miles long and 7 miles wide. But spending the money to build a city as big as Plymouth is unrealistic, and it's unlikely that Montserrat will be restored to its former glory. Number 4. Memorial Mound. Clyde Booth was a gravedigger who dreamed of providing the public with a unique alternative to traditional burials. He turned this vision into a reality in 1992 when he opened an underground mausoleum in Bessemer, Alabama called Memorial Mound. The unconventional resting place sat 8 feet below the ground, built into a hill. It had a visitor's area that contained a chapel and a computer that visitors could use to view pictures and videos of their loved ones. It also had a marble wall where people left items in memory of the deceased who were laid to rest there. Behind the marble wall, there was a warehouse-like room filled with metal racks for holding caskets. In this area, which was off-limits to the public, coffins were stacked up to 10 feet high. The lower slots came at a much higher cost than those near the top. Booth's unique idea didn't attract as many customers as he thought it would, and only a handful of these spaces were ever filled. So he closed Memorial Mound in 1996 after selling less than a dozen burials over a 4-year period. Relatives were allowed to continue visiting the mausoleum until 2000, when the building permanently closed its doors. The site soon fell into a sad state of decay. Vandals looted it for scrap metal and left it in disarray, while curious urban explorers broke in to have their own look around. Photos of the dilapidated property that surfaced in 2014 showed broken glass, embalming supplies, display caskets, and decaying skeletal human remains, including at least one body in an open coffin. Authorities had known about the building's neglected state for a while, but the images finally prompted them to act. They increased security measures at the property and took the remains of 7 people to the local coroner's office so surviving family members could make final arrangements. Sadly, some of the graves had been ransacked by then, and someone even took a human skull as a morbid memento of their trespassing adventure into the mausoleum. Number 3. Port Arthur. Port Arthur opened in 1830 as a timber station on the Australian island of Tasmania. It was turned into a prison in 1853 when Britain began sending its most hardened criminals there. Those who reoffended after their first conviction or who proved too difficult to handle in a traditional jail ended up at Port Arthur, where boys as young as 9 years old were sent. The prison had some of the highest security measures in the British penal system and was deemed inescapable. Instead of physically punishing prisoners, which was standard at other institutions, the guards at Port Arthur psychologically tortured the inmates. Prisoners were kept as isolated from one another as possible. They were forced to wear hoods over their faces to keep them silent, and they were cut off entirely from any form of meaningful human contact. This hardline experimental policy, known as separate prison system, was supposedly designed to give inmates an opportunity to reflect on the behavior that landed them behind bars. But the sensory deprivation and solitude did more harm than good, taking a severe psychological toll and causing many prisoners to go crazy. The disturbing daily occurrences at Port Arthur were brought to light during a penal reform movement, and in 1877 the prison was abandoned. Several of the property's decaying buildings were auctioned off, and people didn't seem to mind seeing these remnants of a dark and shameful chapter in history get erased. Eager to rebrand the area's reputation, locals established an entirely new town. But curious visitors continued to visit the ruins, and activists campaigned to preserve what's left of the site. Port Arthur fell under government management during the 1970s. It became a UNESCO World Heritage Site in 2010, ensuring that the inhumane suffering that went on at the prison will never be forgotten. Number 2. Takakanuma Greenland Amusement Park. Japan's Fukushima Prefecture is primarily known throughout the world as the site of a catastrophic nuclear accident that happened at a power plant in 2011. But it's also home to an obscure abandoned amusement park called Takakanuma Greenland. It's tucked into a rural mountainous area outside the city of Hobara and is allegedly impossible to find on any map or GPS. The park opened in 1973 and closed just 2 years later. Ticket sales were low and the owners claimed they planned to renovate, hoping to attract more visitors. On the other hand, locals claimed that Takakanuma Greenland closed because multiple people died on the rides. It reopened in 1986 but struggled to compete with newer and bigger amusement parks like Tokyo Disneyland. The park closed for good in 1999 and its rides and attractions were simply left to rot. Urban explorers have captured photos of the heavily rusted and overgrown Ferris wheel, roller coaster, and other rides, along with the park's graffiti-covered entrance. Some claim that the site's disturbing history is exaggerated, and that a lot of information has gotten lost in translation because of cultural misunderstandings and language barriers. But if you ask others, the tragic stories about what may or may not have happened at Takakanuma Greenland only add to the eeriness of the secluded ruins. Number 1. Odessa Catacombs. Beneath the streets of Odessa, Ukraine, there's a 1,600-mile-long network of tunnels known as the Odessa Catacombs. There are over 1,000 entrances to the system, which date back to the late 18th century. The catacombs originally functioned as underground stone mines for harvesting coquina, a sedimentary rock that was commonly used as building material in the growing city. They span three levels and consist of caves, tunnels, and abandoned quarries, which are not all connected. Odessa experienced a huge commerce boom from 1819 to 1859. At the time, mining activities were largely unregulated, allowing prospectors to dig into the ground on a whim, hoping to secure a fortune. It eventually became so problematic that mining was banned in central Odessa after the Russian Revolution in 1917. During World War II, the tunnels were used for hiding Soviet partisans. Different historical chapters are revealed in various parts of the complex. One part, known as the Wild Area, features inscriptions, symbols, paintings, and graffiti of unknown origins and meanings. Decaying human remains have also been found within the network, which continues to expand in parts of Odessa where mining is still allowed. Thanks for watching. Which of these scary places would you most like to visit? Let us know in the comments and don't forget to hit the subscribe button. How about a thumbs up while you're here so we know you want to see more videos like this? Thanks again and we'll see you next time for another amazing video right here on American Eye.